Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Will you direct your attention now to the field once again? And welcome Ken Singleton to throw out today's ceremonial first pitch in honor of his retirement to his good friend and fellow broadcaster, Michael Kay. Yankees games, and best of luck in your retirement.
And that right there is a two-headed monster. What a combination as Kenny gets it to the plate. And then how about Kay with the scoop?
I talked to Michael earlier today, and I asked him, did you bring a glove to the ball game? And he said, no, I'm going to have to borrow someone else's. So the glove that he borrowed was obviously a golden glove. Nice snag by Kay behind the dish, Flash.
You know what? I got to give Kenny Singleton a lot of props, though. He went out there with a sport coat on, right? I would have taken that jacket off. You could see if Michael Kay was in a more athletic position, he could have caught that ball right in front of home plate. He decided to go with the one knee down, which we all know limits your range and your mobility back there. I do give him credit, though. The pick, which we've seen a lot of catchers go with this year, he made the play. He didn't look real confident doing it, but you got to give him credit at the end of the day.
Now he's got to dust off the right knee, by the way, of the suit, and Kenny goes right to the top of the mound. That's key as well.
How cool is Kenny, by the way? He's got the aviator sunglasses on, right to the top of the mound. He obviously knows his way around a baseball field. Bob, you gave his resume, and a wonderful tribute by the Yankees to Kenny, allowing him to throw that pitch out today for the Yankee fans to recognize him. Everyone is going to miss Kenny's commentary on the games.
Yeah, I really enjoyed seeing that resume, right? Because we know Kenny as the human being and our friend. But then you look at the baseball numbers and how great of a player he was, a switch hitter with power in today's game. You know, on-base guy, it would have been so valuable. So it's kind of cool that when you have a resume at the end of your career that has an amazing playing career and just as impressive in the booth, and we get to know this guy and call him a friend, that's pretty special.
And I love his story, too, Jack, about the fact that you wouldn't think he'd be a Yankees announcer as a longtime Oriole and winning a world championship with them, but George Steinbrenner knew he was a New York guy and had the Yankees' best interest at heart.
It's a fantastic story, and I'm glad that Kenny mentioned that when he was saying goodbye yesterday. He's told all of us this story, but it's clear how important that was for him.
Well, today we celebrate Kenny, and all week long we've been celebrating the fact that Broadway is back for New York, and that's a good thing. And right now, let's get it back to the stadium for the national anthem.